next bout is a featherweight bout scheduled for 6 rounds between 2 lovely ladies, one from Kenya and one from Tanzania. From Kenya, a lovely lady who started a pro boxing this year, 2023. She's had 3 bouts and won all 3. This will be her 4th. Coming in the red corner, PRAXIDES Anyango! Remember, you can catch all the action, Finix Sports on YouTube. The hashtag on social media is Finix Fight Night. Thank you to Sportpesa. Thank you to Finix Casino. Thank you to Avi Fitness. Oh, the lady of the match. Coming in the red corner with her whole team ready. That, ladies and gentlemen, is PRAXIDES Anyango! All right. With 7 fights won, with 7 fights, won 2 and lost 4, all the way from the Republic of Tanzania, ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Halima Bandola! Halima making her way to the stage. This bout is scheduled for 6 rounds. This match This match will be officiated by 3 judges, Charles Chuma, Charles Olo, Linda Abok. And the referee for this match is one Martin Ndaria. May everyone leave the ring and leave just the 2 boxers.
Boxers, this is your match. Remember, I'm your referee tonight. When I say stop, you stop. When I say break, you break. No rabbit punch, no headbutt, and may the best box come in. Remember to protect yourself at all times. Shake hands.
All right, you've had it from Martin Doria. May the best boxer win.
So another 6-round fight that has been scheduled for the evening in the Finix Fight Night. The World Alliance Boxing Association, in conjunction with the Kenya Professional Boxing Commission.
Seconds away, round one!
At the Nyayo National Stadium, it's Halima Bandola from Tanzania, who's boxing Kenya's PRAXIDES ODUOR. Halima Badora has got 7 fights to her credit. She's won 2 of them, lost 4 of them. One was a draw, and Praxidis has had 3 fights so far. She turned pro only this year, so it's a very fast, it's a 4th fight so far. She is on the right of your screen with her back to us at the moment. He's fighting Halima, who seems to be a little bit taller and might just have a longer reach as well. And plus, she's got the experience. But a good throw from Praxidis seems to be working in her favor in the very first round of a scheduled 6-round fight. But again, experience matters as well in pro boxing. If you look at the number of fights that Halima has had, they're double what Praxidis has, Benson. What do you think then that would help or not help in a match of boxing?
It won't help that much, considering that she has lost most of the fights.
Oh, you and mean you for Halima?
Yeah.
And as but losing is an experience as well. It tells you where you've lost, where you can improve on.
Yeah, sure. But winning are much better than... much better experience than losing.
Yeah, you're right. So there'll be trading punches here. Now, Halima, this is what I was attesting to the experience, has released, I think, 2 left punches earlier on in the nick of time when she avoided the punches coming from Praxidis. But Praxidis knows exactly when to hit and when to stay away from it. She's on the right of your screen throwing a 1-2 and another left that has landed on Halima.
Although Halima
seems to be the one who looks like she's really studying the game, isn't she?
Yeah, no. Praxidis is doing well so far. And I hope maybe, I wish her corner was monitoring Halima. Because Halima is moving only on the left side.
Okay.
Left side.
So well, in the first round, she's been moving only on the left side. What's the danger of that? Or what's the advantage of that?
You get predicted.
Oh, you become very predictable.
You become
very easy to read.
Yeah.
So then what do you do then after you've read her? You go on to that side?
No. You just fake her so that she can go that side and then you throw a right hook.
Oh,
like
okay.
He's moving on the right.
So you lead her onto that side and then throw a hook from that side.
Yeah, sure.
Let's hope that the Praxidis corner has been reading that. We are into round 2 of a scheduled 6-round fight between Kenya's Praxidis Odour, who has just... done her third. She had a very heavy punch that went to Halima's head earlier on. It didn't seem to really perturb her that much, but that swing with the open palm was a little bit heavy. And then she threw a right as well that went to Praxidis. Praxidis seems to have a long reach, but you know, she's not moving in there. She's staying away from her own reach, so that means she's not getting very close as she should. Do you think, Benson?
And that's the strategy that she continue using.
It's a good strategy then.
Yeah.
She's tall. Oh, that's a flurry of punches that has come from Praxidis. A 1-2-3-1 that has caught Halima unexpectedly. You're right, Benson. Halima becomes very predictable, and even when she's going to throw the punches. Now they're all trying to get as much as they can while tangling here. Referee says break. Do boxers often try to take advantage of that time when you're holding each other?
Yeah, because any punches can hurt you. Even if the judge... or the ref won't want the other opponent, it has already hurt.
Yeah, it has already injured you.
Even
if they get a warning after that. But the injury is already there. Another chance for a break here in the second round of a scheduled 6-round fight between Halima Bandora of Tanzania. She weighed in at 57.3 kgs. Praxidis is a heavier one at 58 in the weigh-in yesterday. But in terms of experience, Halima is supposed to have a lot of experience. But she's lost 3 of her fights. 4 of them. She's lost 4 of them and won only 2 of the 7 fights that she has had.
You see, she's moved. Anytime she's moving on the
on the left side, yes. And that is something that you said the corner should have noticed and worked with it to find out exactly what they should do. Well, they've slowed down a bit now.
I think fatigue has started cutting up with them.
I mean, it's just too early. It's 2 rounds. I mean, this is just came in a little bit too early. Again, they have to hang on a bit and find out what's going on. Got a couple of other fights that are still lined up for the evening. This is only the 3rd one of 6 fights. And Albert Kimaro of Tanzania will be fighting Baina Mazola in the next fight. Daniel Wanyonyi of Kenya as well will step into the ring again against Ramadan Kaminja of Tanzania. Later on, Rayton Okwiri in the main fight, middleweight fight, versus Chikodi Makana. He's actually from Malawi. When he comes in onto the ring, he will be trying to challenge. Now, it's round three now. The second round, not very eventful. Not many punches thrown in there, Benson.
Yeah, but I have Praxidis winning that round. So she has two rounds on her back.
So far?
Yeah, so far.
Well, that's the record of... Baina Mazola, who will be coming in the next fight. We'll get to that when we get there. But the second round of the featherweight fight between Halima Badora and Praxidis Odour is just trying to liven up a bit. There was just one of those punches that was thrown that didn't quite land. And I think there Halima did very well to duck out of those long-range heavy punches that were coming from Praxidis. Yeah. It's round three now. What do you expect in this round? Oh, more punches, do you?
I think her corner told her that she was losing the fight.
So she needs to work harder now.
Yeah, she needs to change her strategy.
And well, she lands that's one what left punch.
And that's what she's doing.
Halima also tried to land one. And they got too close and have to weigh out what to do from a little bit of a distance. That left side is where Halima is still going all the time. She tries to come in with a hard punch, but he's caught in a 1-2 by Praxidis. Well, Praxidis, the one advancing most of the time, has a right that lands, but the swing totally misses. Problem with a swing when it misses is the momentum can throw you off balance, and you might come in for a very hard counter right if you don't watch out. Well, this Praxidis trying to get in as much as she can into this fight. And Halima looking very, very, very composed in spite of the fact that she has sucked in some heavy punches that have come from Praxidis, who's on the right of your screens at the moment. Praxidis from Kenya, and Halima from Tanzania. Almost losing her footing, Halima. She's backpedaling a bit as well and swinging still on that left side. Throws one punch and leaves, but it's of no impact, doesn't get there as well. Oh, that's a left that goes very forcefully in, and a good right. She doesn't follow it up with a left. And that's a problem, that each of them is just having one punch that lands, but the, you know, follow-up punch doesn't get there.
Yeah, they lack follow-up.
The follow-up punch is not getting there.
Yeah, in pro boxing, you need to watch your opponent very... If you hurt him, you need to do a follow-up.
You must. You follow up on the injury and inflict some more.
Yeah, sure.
Well then. Backpedaling a bit, Halima. And Praxidis trying to throw a jab. It's not a straight jab. Well then, I think that will be the end of that round. Not very eventful again, I might say. Not many punches thrown in there. Not many of them that have landed. Hoping that they're going to land the punches. Somebody has got to tell them to jab straight, Benson.
Yeah, Praxidis, she's taller. She'll throw more jabs. And then one, two. She should throw, many times she should throw 1-2.
Well, here it is again. We'll take snippets of what happened in that round. So they clashed into punches there. None of them was going directly. So all the punches missed there, except for Praxidis, who threw a heavy right ultimately that caught Halima squarely on the face. She's turning now on the right side, not on the left. And that, again, is not going well for Halima. She's actually setting herself up for very heavy blows that might come from Praxidis.
Yeah, sure. So far, I have Praxidis winning those three rounds, the first three rounds.
Well, we're going into round four now.
The only way Halima can win this fight is by maybe a knockout, which I don't think will happen.
Why not? It's boxing.
Yeah, sure. You see, at the late rounds, both of you get fatigued.
Well, that's so a big, heavy right that came from Praxidis. Pardon me, Benson, I had to go into that one. Now it seems like Halima is turning on her right, swinging on her left foot, using the left foot as a fulcrum, and trying to become unpredictable at the moment. Trying to keep Praxidis at bay. It seems to be working for a moment as Praxidis, well, gets another left in. It seems to have slipped. Oh, she should know that she shouldn't wait and look the other direction. The fight is still on. It's only the referee can send her to a neutral corner to have that addressed, but he shouldn't stop to look at anything. Wow, that was a big mistake by Praxidis.
A very big mistake. You remember the ref told both of them, protect yourself at all times.
At all times, yes. And don't stop. I mean, it's boxing. Jabs are coming. That was a would have been a costly mistake here. Oh, no.
There was a high bar.
Yeah. But she went in so hard. Praxidis, Mazola herself went in so hard. And I think it had an impact. And she has had to go to her corner. I think the referee at this point should send Praxidis to the neutral corner, not to the red corner. She should be on the neutral corner, shouldn't she?
I think he has not noticed yet.
Well, that's the first thing you do as a referee. Send the other boxer to the neutral corner and then come. But I think there must have been a headbutt. Although there was a very heavy left jab that came from Praxidis, and then she slipped there. And this is where she made the mistake. She was looking the other side. She got a punch right onto the face, didn't she?
If it was hard, maybe...
That's the result of the headbutt. It was not intentional, but occasionally fights have been stopped because of this, because of what we call technical knockouts come from such injuries, don't they, Vincent?
But mostly in the if the bout has not passed three rounds.
Here she is now. She's gone to the neutral corner. Finally, she's been sent there. You're saying if the bout has not gone into three rounds?
Yeah, it's not supposed to be a technical knockout.
Okay, there is a slip again. She slipped on her left foot, and then she decided to look at what's going on there. Dangerously got a punch going onto the face, and HALIMA could have taken advantage of this at that moment. But this was not an intentional headbutt, but it's got her bleeding from the forehead, and she's wincing in pain at the moment as Praxidis is looking from a distance, also pondering what is going on. We might just get a chance to see that again. A left that went into the face of Praxidis. Oh, she made a mistake of looking that side. She could have come in for a very heavy left swing.
You see, that's one of the mistakes many boxers make.
Yeah, I don't know, but the bell seems to have gone here. And I think the doctor might have to come and check exactly how deep or how bad that cut is before a decision is made on whether this fight can continue or not. It's six rounds. And we were just in the third round. It's the third fight of the evening. So still waiting for a decision on where this is going to be going. Albert Kimario and Baina Mazola are actually next in a six-round super bantamweight fight. And then after that, there will be Daniel Wanyonyi, who Kenyans know very well for having stepped into the ring recently against Mandonga of Tanzania. They're playing Ramadan Kalinja in an eight-round super middleweight fight, and later on, Rayton Okwiri will be fighting for a middleweight bout with Chikodi Makana of Malawi. The gloves are off here. This fight is over, isn't it, Benson?
Yeah, it's over.
Now so this will be a TKO.
Yeah, that's a TKO. They'll go, if not so, maybe they may go, in amateur, in such a case, they usually go to the scorecard. But in pro, it will be a TKO.
In pro, it's obvious that it's a technical knockout. You've been knocked out on a technicality that you cannot continue the fight. And this will be given to Praxidis ODUOR. So she will be winning her fourth fight here on a TKO. Ended quicker than was expected. And Praxidis will be oozing confidence now at the end of that fight. Oh, the corner is celebrating it, isn't it?
Sure. And even the corner, talk to her.
Yeah. And you see, must have told her what to do.
Yeah, when you are in such a case, when you sleep, you don't have to show that it's not a pun that caught me. I just sleep. No, yeah. Anyone saw what happened. So you should just walk away and continue boxing.
Well then, she knows that now. The fans, not quite sure what happened there until they're told that it's a technical knockout. But they've come out in large numbers at the Yarra National Stadium for the Finix Fight Night. The World Alliance Boxing Association, in conjunction with the Kenya Professional Boxing Commission, fight. Six bouts lined up for the evening. And we are through with bout number three. We're now going to bout number four. Now let's look at the tactics. She mostly was trying to throw some very heavy lefts. But you can see every time that when she throws a left, she was trying to come in with the right all the time. The motion was always there.
Yeah, the problem is he's throwing a punch while coming with the head. It's not supposed... You should let your hand go.
Well, fourth round, TKO. Awarded to It's going to go to Praxidis of Kenya because of that cut that was opened up on the face of Halima Bandora, and she couldn't continue with the fight. So we're going to move on to the fourth bout of the evening. But for Praxidis, this will be a good time. I mean, to increase your record, to improve your record, Benson, all the time is usually a good thing.
Absolutely, absolutely, absolutely.
Oh, that's but a big bandage so on the face of Halima.
So far, having four punches and the year has not yet ended is good for Praxidis.
It's good for her. Well, the cut is not good for Halima at all.
He scored the blue corner 27 points. The second judge, Charles Olo, scored the red corner 28 points and the blue corner 29 points. Judge number three, Linda Abok, scored red corner 29 points and blue corner 28 points. Like I told you earlier, the match went on for four rounds, scheduled for six, stopped by the referee Martin Doria. Ladies and gentlemen, winner by TKO, Praxidis Anyango. Praxidis, after celebrating, you can go and have a chat there with Sabrina, who's waiting for you. Remember, you can catch all the action online on Finix Sports, the YouTube channel, the YouTube page. You can go to social media, take pictures, share with the world. This is the first of many bouts, courtesy of Finix Sports, Finix Casino, Sport Pesa, Avi Fitness,